My guest today first achieved distinction as one of India's foremost dancing couples. As husband and wife, their performance on stage used to be magical. Then he decided to get married for a second time and make it a threesome. Now all three live together in quite an exceptional family. Here to talk about their lives are Raja, Radha and Kaushalya Reddy. Welcome to the program.
Thank you very much.
You know, it's the relationship between the three of you that most people find truly intriguing. All three of you are first cousins to begin with. Then the two ladies are sisters, and both of them are your wives. Does that make for fun, jealousy, or just confusion?
No confusion for us.
It's a happiness.
But happiness.
Really?
And yeah, jealousy to others, yes.
Jealousy to others.
Yes.
That's why we call him, you're not Raja, but Maharaja Raja.
Tell me then, what does it feel like when you realize that your sister is also your husband's wife?
When I got married to him, I didn't realize, nor I thought of her as his wife. I was madly in love and I just wanted to marry him, that's it.
And it didn't matter that he was already married to your sister?
It struck me later.
What about you? He was your husband, Radha, well before he became your sister's. Do you like sharing him?
I don't mind. She's my sister.
Would it have been more difficult if she hadn't been your sister?
Maybe.
Actually, the truth is that our mother-in-law was very keen that he get married, as my sister had not conceived. And when they were talking about his other marriage, she thought it better that when I proposed to him that I would like to marry, she thought this is the best thing that it was happening.
So your mother-in-law, in a sense, forced a second marriage upon you?
Yes.
But you would rather he didn't get married a second time? Difficult question to answer.
Yeah.
You don't want to say yes, but your heart says yes for you. Let's go back to the very beginning, Raja.
Yeah.
The first marriage was the marriage between you and Radha. I gather it happened because both your parents promised each other that their children would get married. Is that true?
Yes, yes. In our Telangana, we have this system like sister's brother's daughter. So my mother's own brother's daughter, Radha. When I was born and my mother took promise from her father, Radha's father, that if you have daughter, you have to give to my son. That was the promise.
And so she it was settled by the parents?
Yes.
But not only Telangana, all south. We have a system like this.
Yeah, you down were south. Five yeah. when you got married, he was 11.
11, yes.
Yes.
Do you
yes.
remember the marriage ceremony?
I don't know anything.
Nothing at all?
No.
So when did you realize that the two of you were man and wife?
When we are
playing together
and in some festivals, then when was I 10, so my grandmother said, you know, Raja, your husband, then I feel shy and I ran away.
So till then you thought he was just a simple friend?
Yeah.
Yeah.
She was just playing because he was a cousin and he was coming from another town. That's
but
it.
Before 14, when she's matured, then only she came as wife to me. You know, in festivals and some social gatherings, we used to play together, we used to sit together, and we used to watch Bhagavatam together throughout the night. And whenever any function in my house, she used to come. And we know that we are husband and wife, but we like friends.
In fact, you're absolutely right. It was only when Radha's mother was opposed to your becoming a dancer
yes.
that the two of you ran away together.
Yes.
Where did you go and what did you do?
No, we came to Hyderabad.
But all on your own?
Yes. I was not having money. And Radha had just given 1 rupee to the potter in the village. Go and tell Raja that my mother's parents are planning for some other marriage and they are trying to take divorce from Raja. So she gave 1 rupee and that fellow came to me and I went to Kotalgaon and we ran away by train. And I was not having any single penny in the train. I sold out my t-shirt.
As he says, you had no money. Those were difficult times. But were you happy?
I don't know, that time is very, only 15 years old, I don't know anything, then I feel, when first salary given to me, only 100 rupees, that time I became very shocked to see 100 rupees.
Were you in love with him at the time?
I love, I saw 100 rupees, I don't know what to, I,
So you were financially very hard off, and you weren't sure whether you loved him at all.
No, she used to love me because, you know, when they wanted to take divorce and they said, no, we are not going to send my daughter to a dancer, to a beggar. Beggar means, you know, the dancers of the dancing family, they go to, from house to house by performing during the daytime also in our in Andhra. So her parents thought that future of my daughter. So when they said, no, I'm not going to marry anybody except Baba. Baba means brother-in-law.
The realization struck her when she saw the 100 rupees.
She suddenly realized, I may love this man, but he's very poor. Tell me, it was 5 years after they ran away, and ironically, you were 5 yourself at the time, that your parents sent you to stay with your sister and your brother-in-law. Why did they do that?
Because she was lonely. She used to cry all the time. My father is the one who persuaded made my mother agree to send me to Hyderabad.
So you came as a companion for Radha?
Yeah, as a younger sister. Yeah.
Then when did you fall in love with her husband instead?
79.
But were you aware that you were falling in love with your sister's husband?
No, it was not like that. Actually, what happened was I was touring with them, Southeast Asia. And during that performance, all those ladies, you know, they would flock around him. You know, kiss him, and they used to just talk about his performance. That's when I realized that he's really handsome and quite manly, you know, very masculine. He's not feminine.
But one can consider one's brother-in-law handsome without falling in love with him.
Sorry, again?
One can consider one's brother-in-law handsome without falling in love with him.
But it just happened. I had no control over my heart then.
Did you feel guilty that he was in fact your sister's husband?
I felt guilty much, much later. It was too late by then.
But not at the time?
Not at that time.
Were you aware
after the marriage, yes.
that
yes.
your younger sister was falling in love with your husband?
Yes, she came one day to me. She told me, I want to marry Baba. Then I'm inside this very shock. Then I don't show my on my face. Okay, you want to marry, you can marry, I said.
But inside you must have been deeply hurt.
Yeah, hurt.
She was hurt, and she told me that she went into the bathroom and cried also. But that was much, much later she told me that. That's where I felt guilty, what I have done to my
sister. But she is the one who sent message to my father-in-law and my mother-in-law that Kaushalya wants to marry, and you make arrangements.
Did you send that message?
Yes. Yeah.
Yes. And
she's so in other words, you were sacrificing
yourself. I gave her my jewelry also.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you gave your jewelry to your sister to help her marry your husband?
Yes.
You were 14 the day you proposed to Raja.
15, I guess.
How did it happen?
What do you mean? How did it happen? It just happened.
But what do you mean? I mean, one doesn't normally go up to one's brother-in-law and say, I want to marry you.
It's amazing that I did that. I just went to him. I said, listen, I'm in love with you. Would you like to marry me? That's it. And he just said, okay, I don't mind marrying, but wait for a year.
Was that the answer, Raja?
Yes. I was a bit shocked when she proposed to me.
And just a little bit shocked, not more.
Yeah. Bit shocked.
A little bit pleased as well?
You know, I noticed in Southeast Asia, in Malaysia, Singapore, she was trying to, you know, give a romantic style towards me. I noticed, but...
You realized that she was flirting with you when she was only 14?
There was a difference, you know, in the look. Actually, I noticed that, but she's my sister in life. She
it's
came
a
as
lie.
A child.
I never revealed.
No. But that was a great help, Karan. You see, in the dance also, in the life also,
no,
that was
see,
a great help.
He married both of us for dancing and music. That's
a fact. Till now, he has not said he loves
us.
The truth is, he wants one wife to dance with, the other wife to conduct the music. As simple as that.
So in other words, he's married two professionals rather than two wives.
No, please tell me. Now.
But there's an interesting bit to this story you haven't told me. When you went to propose to him at the age of 14 or 15, he says he told you, wait a year.
Yes.
But right. I gather that you gave him an ultimatum, didn't you?
That's yes,
true.
Yes.
So
what did you say?
I just said, abhi, neither kabini, right now or never.
And what did you say to that?
I said, I don't mind, but you ask Virakka. Then she asked Radha. Radha was very happy, you know, from...
Let's let Radha answer that one. Were you very happy when she asked if she can marry your husband?
Yes, I said before also.
But not very happy.
Yeah.
With reluctance.
Yes.
So inside you were hurting,
yeah.
But you knew that this was something you had to agree to.
Yeah. I guess the another truth to the whole thing is because she thought it better to have a stranger rather than have a stranger as the second wife, you know, sister getting married to her husband
and
would
then
be
there
more
was
understanding.
The pressure of your mother, who was anyway
exactly.
determined.
There was pressure, but Karanji, not because of the pressure she married to me. Not because of the pressure that
no,
I was
I didn't
in love
marry,
with her.
Yeah.
It was only the love. And it was only the profession. After the marriage, I realized that my profession will be very good when Kaushalya is also there in with me.
Except for one thing, that after you married Kaushalya, you kept it a secret for 2 years. Were you embarrassed
no,
about what
not,
you done?
No. There was no need to tell everybody. See, I married her in the village, in the temple.
No,
I married
proper
before
marriage.
The proper we marriage.
Did. So then why keep it a secret?
On the only the Delhiites, they were not aware of it.
Because you were sure that they wouldn't understand.
Oh, I don't know why he didn't reveal. Then I got so upset with him. Then my sister said.
So you were upset?
I was very upset because I wanted the world to know that I was married to him.
And you suspected?
And people would talk.
Yeah. And you suspected that he was keeping it secret because he
no,
was
I
a little embarrassed?
No, I never suspected. No. It was not like that. In fact, I didn't like what people were saying about us. So I wanted the world to know that we were married. There was nothing fishy about the whole relationship.
Now today, of course, you have two wives. They're sitting on either side of you, one in red, the other in green. How do you divide your time between them?
It's very easy. Whatever the time she wants, I have to devote that time, and whatever the time she wants, I have to devote.
And what happens
and
when they both want you at the same time?
No, they will not.
The truth is,
they will not. Because as the elder sister, she sacrificed for her younger sister.
She's more understanding.
Yes,
the truth
more
is,
understanding.
Like the house is still together. And we are still bounded together is because of my sister's understanding.
In other words, she keeps this threesome going.
Exactly.
Yes.
But
she's
you're saying
very
that it's her sacrifice.
And you can see it on her face, you know. She looks very saintly and very nice person.
Oh.
And she says, Karan, you see, the
you're
marriage,
the one.
Marriage is not only the physical relationship. Marriage is the Atma and Paramatma, the union with the universe.
Marriage is something
yes.
else as well. Marriage is children and both of you have children.
Exactly.
You agreed to the marriage. Because at that point of time, you didn't have a child.
Yes.
Thereafter, you had a daughter.
Yes.
When your daughter was born, did you regret the fact that you'd agreed to another marriage?
No.
It was too late.
I don't know.
It never struck,
yes.
actually. It never struck her.
Your daughter's in college today.
Yeah.
What does she make of this three-way relationship? Is she embarrassed?
No, they don't.
Not
no,
at all?
No.
No, in the beginning she was. My Yamini was saying that is Kaushalya. Kaushalya.
She would always
like,
say.
Kaikeyi to me. You know,
not a very nice comparison at all.
Yeah, she would always say,
stories.
How come the Snow White stepmother was so rude and cruel? And how was this one? Even the Sleeping Beauty's mother, how come you are not? And how is that I have two mothers? Then she used to also say, oh, one mom is for discipline, the other one is for pampering.
And which one are you?
I'm the disciplined one.
So you're the nasty mother. But in fact, Kaushalya, you also have a daughter.
Yeah.
She's in school. How does she respond to this menage a trois? Because in her case, mummy is also auntie, daddy is also uncle, her sister is also her cousin. It's all a little confusing, isn't it?
It's not at all confusing. You should ask them, actually. It's just that they have accepted the relationship. They don't find anything strange. They're very happy. In fact, my daughter is more close to my sister.
Yes, my daughter close
no,
to
No, she asked me, Bhavana
sister.
Asked me that, you know, when she used to go to school, in modern school, junior school, she asked me, how come daddy, everybody has got only one mother, how, I got two mothers.
What did you say?
I said, Lord Krishna had 8 wives and Lord Venkateshwar has 2 wives. So why not me also, I have 2 wives, but I just explained her.
Well justified.
I must of course put to you what the world outside says. In the eyes of the world, they say, Raja, this is bigamy, if not also incest.
No, it's okay. As long as we are happy and we are not doing any harm to the society, I think the world should have no problem with us.
No, but somebody asked me that he's against law. Raja, how did you marry Kaushalya? But when Radha has no objection, so what?
What's wrong? I don't care
the world. They say whatever the people suck. And why do they go to pray Lord Venkateshwara? He has 2 wives, Alimelu Manga and Padmavati.
So if Lord Venkateshwar can have 2 wives and if Krishna could have had many more,
why can't Raja?
What about something else? It's not just a question of bigamy or incest. It's not just a question of illegality. People turn around and say, it's immoral of you to have done this.
Oh,
I have
okay.
done a great favor to the society, a great favor to the country.
Explain.
Yes, if Kaushalya marries somebody else, he could have had 4 or 5 children. So with me he had only one daughter.
You mean by marrying Kushalya, you yes. haven't let her have a second child?
No.
So you've sacrificed as well, have you?
No. In fact, I didn't want to have a baby. That's the truth.
He forced himself upon you.
No, my daughter, my sister's daughter was very keen that I have a baby. It was for her I had.
Radha, there is something else the world says, because as you know, the world has involved themselves in commenting upon your life very openly. They say that you're the one who's got the raw end of the deal. You're relegated to the kitchen, you're kept at home. Do they treat you well?
Yes, of course.
My gosh, she is the main person of the house. How can you even say that?
Except that you're not letting her answer. You're saying it
for her. You ask us how she treats us. You ask her.
No,
she's not quite a temperamental person.
You did say a moment ago that you had to accept the second marriage as a sacrifice. Now, do they treat you well?
Yes, of course. Somebody's sacrifice is good for a house.
So in other words, you keep seeing it as a sacrifice. It's something that you had to do rather than wanted to do.
But that's the truth.
I want to do.
That?
Yeah, I do agree. Because to be frank, but it's not easy to accept another woman in the life of your husband. It's tough.
I don't mind marrying Kaushalya as my husband. But I don't want to dance with Raja Kaushalya.
Yeah, that is the condition she put me. That
so Raja as your dancing partner is more important than Raja as your husband. You accept that?
Yes. I run away that for only dance. Then I don't want to give up dance.
Raja, there's one other thing I gather, and in fact Kaushalya hinted at this earlier on, that you remain extremely attractive to women. There's a Mexican lady, I'm told, who wants to join this three-way relationship and become the fourth member.
Did
you battle to keep her out?
No, I fought with him. I was just married to him then.
And he was actually genuinely ready to bring her in?
No way.
She was keen. Probably she was more or less like me.
Are you ever scared that just as Radha had to share him with you, one day the two of you may have to share him with a third woman?
I want it. I told him, I'm not like my sister. I'm not very, a very understanding kind of a person. I'm very possessive.
Two is enough.
Yeah, more than enough.
Raja, is two enough or do you want a third woman?
No.
He
can have affairs.
She proposed. She proposed. She wanted me to come to Mexico whenever I want and I'll remain here only. Let your two wives stay in India like that. She proposed, but she was dead against.
Let's take a break at that intriguing point. I want to come back and ask you how this has affected your dance, or whether in a strange way dance has made it actually possible. That's the subject after the break. See you in a moment. Welcome back. I'm with the incredible trio Raja, Radha and Kaushalya Reddy. Now, the world knows Radha and Raja as a dancing partnership. Where do you fit into their professional life, Kaushalya?
They can't dance without me. I play the tune.
In other words, they dance to your
my
tune.
Yeah.
Both metaphorically and literally.
That you have to see.
Tell me, Radha, the magic of your dancing partnership is what brought you together. Has that been affected by the confusion in your personal life?
No.
Not even one little bit?
No.
Because they used to say that it's the chemistry between you and Raja, what the critics called the strong man-woman combination, that is the magic of your dance. Now that there's another woman, is the chemistry affected?
No. It has more musical support and strong.
What about the way she puts it? Do you like dancing to her tune?
Only on the stage.
I noticed that you have to be a quick diplomat between the two wives.
No.
I don't want to even dance also her tune. I want to dance his tune. He doesn't want to play my dance for cymbals.
So that's another sacrifice you have to accept.
Yeah. No, but she says, I want him to play for my solo number. You're not going to play. She's pretty clear about it. And whenever she does a solo, it's him.
Tell me something. You hinted at this in part one. Is it dance that has made this otherwise difficult, confusing, emotional relationship possible?
Yeah.
Well, the thing is, whatever the small differences comes, when we go to the room, practice room, we become one. And there are not quarrels at all and big issues, any issue, except small things.
Yes, small fighting too.
Happens all the time.
Yes. Yeah, yeah. In kitchen or something, and when for the children, if they want something, you know, Radha says, let them take this thing. And she said, no, they're not going to take. I don't want them to this thing. Like
actually,
that.
Actually, we spend maximum time in the studio, like 10 to 2 in the morning till the afternoon, then from 4 to 8 in the evening teaching the students. So we are in the studio the most, and we are only thinking about dance, we are doing only dance. So we never get an opportunity to sit down and talk also. Actually, he never even eats with us.
He doesn't eat with you?
Yeah, somehow he doesn't
eat. No, we eat separately.
Yeah, that's the problem. We Akka, time. Me, we eat together.
Do you think there's another woman in his life, this time a cook?
No, it is bathroom.
What's he doing in the bathroom?
Please, God knows, there's a lot of peace there. No ladies around him.
No, he composes new items.
No disturbance.
Choreography.
But he composes in the bathroom.
Yes. Yeah, all the choreography is done in
that
the bathroom.
That is the
Raja,
place
why
where
in the bathroom?
No, that is the place so where I don't get any telephone disturbance. I don't disturb by these two ladies. And I have peace and I can think of the item.
This is very interesting. No one ever realized this, that when a man has two wives, he has to find sanctuary in the bathroom.
Yes, yes.
That's the only place they leave you in peace.
Yes.
So far from being a lucky man, sometimes you're a man with two problems rather than one.
Oh, you
that's
know,
good.
He has no problem at all. We do maximum adjustment. We do all the solving.
Yeah.
He has nothing to do. He's the lucky guy.
He is literally the Lord Krishna of these two gopis.
Definitely. Definitely.
You always wanted to be a dancer, that was your dream, but your parents were dead against it, weren't they?
Yes, Reddy's, you know, those days actually the low class people were dancing actually. And in Kuchipudi the Brahmins, but not Reddy's. Like my father, Radha's father, they used to patronize the performances.
So when the son decided he wanted to be a dancer, they were horrified.
Yes, my father was very unhappy.
You were letting down all the social traditions.
Yes, yes. And sometime after my father died, so I came to Hyderabad, and when I went back to my village to give a performance, there was a social boycott to my mother.
That's right, you had to go to court, in fact, didn't you?
Yes, yes, I went to court.
If your parents had lived today to see not just the incredible success that you've had as dancers, but also this unique and unconventional relationship, would they have been happy and proud, or would they have been a little surprised and shaken?
But there's nothing unique about this relationship. My grandfather, he had three wives.
So it's very much in the family tradition.
It is very much
yes, yes, yes.
The Reddys are men blessed with many wives.
Yes.
Yeah. Like North Indian Chaudhrys.
Yeah.
Landlords. Even Reddys also.
In North India, they have three wives.
So would it surprise you, Raja, if your daughters end up with three husbands?
Oh no.
That's not
permitted. Sorry, Raj. We would not approve of that.
You wouldn't approve of it.
He doesn't like.
So the tradition stops with you.
No, it has to, because it was only the dance. The common thing was dance. See, even I got attracted to him because of dance. My sister also ran away because of dance.
Well, and it's only because of dance that you've been with us. But thank you for this wonderful, warm and open and frank interview. Raja, Radha and Kushalya Reddy speaking openly to face to face. Goodbye.